the latest and the greatest of KDE software on a rock-solid base of Ubuntu. Sounds promising, isn't it? I installed KDE Neon on my office computer 2 months ago, and in this video, I would like to share with you my experience and answer the question, is it the best KDE distribution? When KDE Neon was released for the first time, I thought, wow, this could really become the best KDE distribution. I have finally got a chance to install it on my computer, test it extensively for 2 months, and share my experience with you. By the way, if you are new to this channel, consider subscribing. And I also encourage all my subscribers to activate the bell notification, so you will never miss any new video. After using KDE Neon for 2 months, I can say it is going to stay on my production machine at work for a while. Overall, it is a very good distribution, but it's not the best KDE distribution. Let's have a look at its pros and cons. Let's start with the positive sides of KDE Neon. It is stable. I have not experienced a single crash. And believe me, I use it heavily every day. To give you an idea, my work assumes 4 virtual desktops, and many applications open in each of these desktops. The processor often has to work really hard, performing computations at 100% load in all 12 threads of my processor. I often load almost all 32 GB of RAM. And this computer with KDE Neon works 24/7 with a reboot maybe once per week. So you can rely on KDE Neon to do a lot of work. It is based on Ubuntu. Whether you like it or not, Ubuntu has become a standard as a Linux OS. Many developers first create a dev package specifically for Ubuntu, and later for other distros. There are many third-party repositories created for Ubuntu specifically. And if you have a problem, it is way easier to find a solution for Ubuntu than any other distribution. So you can install any Ubuntu package in KDE Neon, and if you have difficulties installing a program, you also will be able to find a solution relatively quickly. I use KDE Neon for work, so Ubuntu Base was a must for me. It comes clean. KDE Neon comes with no applications pre-installed, except these applications you can see in the menu now. This may be a negative side for new users, but it was a really positive side for me. I prefer to have a clean desktop with minimum packages, so I can install only what I need. These are the graphical programs I installed. There are also some command line programs I installed in addition to this, but I cannot recall them all. KDE Neon has a recent Plasma 5 desktop. If you are my long-term subscriber, you already know I am a big fan of KDE. Plasma 5 is the most powerful and productive desktop for me. I used to run Linux Mint 17 with KDE 4 desktop at work, but when I installed Arch Linux with the latest Plasma 5 on my home computer, it was a little uncomfortable to look at KDE 4 when I knew there was Plasma 5. So having a recent version of Plasma 5 on the solid base of Ubuntu is a perfect setup for a working machine. During the last 2 months, KDE Neon upgraded their Plasma 5 desktop several times. It is Plasma 5.13.3 on KDE Neon User Edition at the moment of recording this video, which is the same version of Plasma desktop as on my home computer with Arch Linux. So you can have quite a recent version of Plasma 5 desktop. If you want to be on the bleeding edge of Plasma desktop, but you don't want to install Arch Linux, you can also install KDE Neon Developer Edition. However, I can say KDE Neon User Edition is also updated regularly, and the difference when a new version of Plasma comes to Arch Linux and KDE Neon User Edition is not that big, maybe a few weeks. So the whole concept of the latest and greatest of KDE software on a rock-solid base of Ubuntu is the most appealing feature of KDE Neon. That's all I wanted to say in terms of pros. Now, let's have a look at some cons. It is not a distribution for new users. You need some experience to run KDE Neon. There are almost no pre-installed applications. You have to install everything you need. Of course, it can be both pros and cons, but I think some new users may have difficulties finding and installing programs they need. Software Center is still not good enough. This is related to the previous point. New users will most likely use the Software Center to install programs and to update their system. From my experience, it doesn't work really well. The Software Center doesn't crash, which is good, but it is very, very slow, regardless whether you install programs or update your system. For me it is okay, I mostly use Synaptic Package Manager to install programs, and I update through the command line. But it may be a problem for those who want to use the Software Center exclusively. Confusion between the package managers, pkcon and apt. KDE Neon recommends using pkcon as a command line package manager. This is different from Ubuntu Package Manager apt, which is also present in KDE Neon. Most users will assume they can use apt because KDE Neon is based on Ubuntu, but KDE Neon recommends using pkcon. I found this information accidentally on the KDE Neon website. It says that pkcon is more reliable to handle the updates. So I use pkcon to update the system, it updates the system, but its command line interface needs to be polished. For example, after the updates, this line shift happens all the time. This is not nice. But to install packages, I use a well-familiar apt or the Synaptic Package Manager. My understanding is that you need to use pkcon to install updates, but apt is fine for the rest. KDE Neon is little outdated in its core. Because it uses Ubuntu long-term support base, the developers need some time after the release of Ubuntu LTS to port it to KDE Neon. For example, when I installed KDE Neon, it was based on Ubuntu 16.04, while there was Ubuntu 18.04 already. It is not a serious problem if you don't need the latest kernel, for example. My computer has a very recent processor, it's Intel Core i7-8700, with integrated Intel Ultra HD graphics 630. To work correctly, it required the kernel 4.15 or later, but KDE Neon had the kernel 4.13 at that time. Luckily, the kernel 4.15 was in the repositories, and I was able to install it. Currently, at the moment of recording this video, KDE Neon comes with the kernel 4.15 by default, but it wasn't the case when I installed it 2 months ago. So, if you need the latest software, you may experience some problem from time to time. I have two more complaints about KDE Neon, which I hope will be fixed soon. Non-Qt apps have problems with tooltips messages. I have mentioned this as a bug in my 7 annoyances of Plasma 5 video. It is still not fixed. As you can see, in some applications, tooltips are simply not readable. You can fix it by going to Settings, Colors, and disable Apply Colors to Non-Qt apps. Now the tooltips are shown normally. It is still surprising to see this problem in KDE Neon. I have seen other distributions fix this problem. Bug in favorite apps. I was not able to remove some of my favorite apps in KDE menu. Normally, you can also remove some of these apps and add your own. The problem was that after the reboot or logout, some removed favorite apps came back. In my case, Kate was showing up again and again after I removed it. I fixed that problem by removing these files. I logged out and logged in and set my favorite apps again. After these steps, everything worked fine. It's not a big bug, but I still think it was worth mentioning. To conclude, KDE Neon is a great distribution if you like Plasma 5 Desktop and Ubuntu Base. But you need to spend quite some time to set up and configure it. Not as much time as you would spend installing and configuring Arch Linux, but still sufficient amount of time. Unfortunately, KDE Neon is not the best KDE distribution. Actually, I would say there is no the best KDE distribution at the moment. If you need something sort of install and start working, try Ubuntu. It is more user-friendly than KDE Neon, but it is also not perfect. Whenever I tried Ubuntu, I always find obvious bugs in it. You can also install Linux Mint 18 KDE. It has a little older version of Plasma 5, but it is still Plasma 5, and it is supported until 2021. It is much better than KDE Neon and Ubuntu in terms of user friendliness and stability, but it has older version of Plasma 5. I may make a video comparing all these KDE distributions, but for now, what is your favorite KDE distribution and why? Please leave a comment below, and thank you for watching!